Breaking developments in a controversial police shooting that's been at the center of the Black Lives Matter movement for months. Not one, but two outside experts have now seemed to clear the officer who fatally shot a 12-year-old in Cleveland, saying he was justified in his actions. And despite that development, Democratic frontrunner Hillary Clinton's now weighing in on the case and not on the side of police. We've got Sheriff David Clarke and Democratic strategist Mark Hanna in just a minute. But first, Trace Gallagher with the investigation into the Rice shooting. Trace.
Shannon, the initial call to police dispatch came in as someone pointing, quote, a probably fake gun, but the fake part was never relayed to the responding officers who pulled their squad car within a few feet of 12-year-old Tamir Rice. Officer Timothy Lohman, who was in training at the time riding in the passenger side, claims he saw Rice reach for a gun in his waistband, then shot and wounded the boy, who died later. Tamir Rice was carrying an airsoft pellet gun, and now two separate reports by two outside investigators say the shooting was reasonable. Lamar Sims, a Colorado prosecutor and use of force expert, issued a 52-page report concluding, quoting here, Officer Lohman's belief that Rice posed a threat of serious physical harm or death was objectively reasonable, as was his response to the perceived threat. Retired FBI agent Kimberly Crawford's report was 8 pages, where she says, quoting again, it is my conclusion that Officer Lohman's use of deadly force falls within the realm of reasonableness under the dictates of the Fourth Amendment. The prosecutor is still vowing to take this to a grand jury, but the Rice family says instead of letting the evidence speak for itself, the prosecutor poisoned the well. Listen.
The Rice family feels now that the grand jury process has been tainted by the prosecutor's conduct, and as a result, they will not receive justice from the criminal justice process under this prosecutor. It's just not going to happen.
The Ohio Highway Patrol also released a report, but it does not offer an opinion, only logistics. Shannon.
All right, Trace, thank you very much for bringing us up to date. All right, despite these reports, Democratic presidential frontrunner Hillary Clinton is being an expert on this now today, sending out a message of support to Tamir Rice's loved ones, saying too many black families are mourning the loss of a child. Last week, Clinton met with some Black Lives Matter activists. On Friday, she sent out a message saying this, quote, racism is America's original sin. And our good friend, Mr. Greg Gutfeld over at The Five, is now suggesting that positions like Mrs. Clinton's are only making things worse.
What would I ask Hillary at Tuesday's debate tomorrow? First, if racism is truly America's original sin, as you just tweeted, why are so many black and brown people risking their lives to come here? Can you explain how, even at our worst, we are still the best? And do you ever worry that pandering to factions only divides an already fractured country?
All right, Sheriff David Clarke of the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office and Mark Hanna, partner at the Truman National Security Project. Welcome to you both, gentlemen.
Thank you, Shannon.
All right, Sheriff, we have two now outside investigations, one by a former FBI agent, I believe, and another by a prosecutor, saying that the officer, you know, lamenting the death of a 12-year-old, but saying the officers acted in a reasonable manner. You got to make split-second decisions, but still there are those who are casting doubt on the case. Sheriff.
Well, first of all, Mrs. Bill Clinton is showing that she is willing to prostitute herself to secure the black vote. Look, she knows that's her ace in the hole when it comes to Bernie Sanders, especially when they get into the primaries in the southern states. She knows better than that. That sort of pandering is unbecoming of somebody who wants to become the next president of the United States. She's well aware as an attorney of the objective reasonableness standard in Graham v. Connor, that officers have to make split-second decisions on how much force and when to use force, and you can't use 20/20 hindsight. She knows that it's the reasonable officer standard. Once you strip away the emotion, the hyperbole, and the rhetoric involved in this tragic case, all that's left are the facts and circumstances, and it's the rule of law standard that has to prevail.
Mark, those are some tough words. And the sheriff's not alone in thinking that Mrs. Clinton is politicizing this to her political benefit. What do
right.
you say?
If pandering to factions, as Greg Gutfeld said, is you know, giving voice to a lot of frustrations in the black community. But let's look at what she actually tweeted, that too many black families are experiencing these tragedies. I don't think that Sheriff Clarke would disagree with that. I don't think he would disagree with the fact that there is still some residual racism in our country.
I would disagree wholeheartedly. Don't put
words
in my mouth.
Sheriff Clarke, I'm sure you've experienced racism in your life.
There is no data or research to suggest that. Show me the data that suggests that law enforcement officers using inordinate amount of force against young black males in the United States.
Okay, let me ask you, do you think it's reasonable that police officers shot and killed within 2 seconds of getting out of their squad car, a trainee, shot and killed a 12-year-old boy, and do you think he would have done it if that boy was white?
Well, first of all, let's get rid of the...
Just yes
the
or
if,
no.
But let me go by the reasonable officer standard. Yes, I do believe they acted very reasonably.
Do you think that's okay in America?
These decisions are made in split seconds as to when to use force and how much to use.
Right.
20-20 hindsight, which is where
you're
coming from,
is an open carry.
Is not the standard.
You know it's legal to carry a gun.
Yeah, a couple of things that are important here is that we are told that the orange tip that is on toy guns, on fake guns, was removed in this case. So officers would not have been able to see that. They were told that somebody was pulling a gun in and out of their clothing.
And
they arrived on the scene without a lot of the facts that we know now, Mark.
Right. And Shannon, I mean, it is true that there was a toy gun involved. It looked realistic. But it's an open carry law.
That's 20-20 hindsight.
Those officers
did not know that at the time,
Sheriff,
and it wouldn't have been reasonable for them to assume that.
Okay.
Right, Mark, let me ask you, because I want to talk with you specifically about the political angle here. As the sheriff rightly pointed out, Mrs. Clinton is a brilliant person. She is a well-trained, well-experienced lawyer. I mean, is it fair to say that she is leveraging something that she knows will incite a certain reaction from people in order to engender support, while ignoring some of the important legal and factual information in this case, Mark?
I think we should all ignore certain legal information in this case because it's not just a legal matter. It's an ethical matter. It's a moral obligation we have. Sheriff Clarke, you said on your Facebook page that Tamir Rice was armed with a realistic-looking replica. You seem to suggest that somehow this 12-year-old boy was at least partly responsible for his own killing. I think that's extraordinarily distasteful. I don't think the officer necessarily intentionally killed somebody. I think this might have been a horrific accident.
All right.
But I don't think these horrific accidents should
I don't have a Facebook page, so I don't know where you're getting that from. But again, it says once you strip away the emotion, what you're coming from, the rhetoric and the hyperbole, the facts and circumstances remain. And it's the reasonable officer standard, and there's no doubt in my mind that these officers will be cleared of any criminal wrongdoing.
This is a tragic situation. But there is still the matter of a grand jury that will have to decide whether there will be criminal charges here, so this case is not over yet. Sheriff Clarke, Mark Hanna, Professor, thank you both for joining us.
Thank you, Shannon.